Hello students, today we'll see how to isolate as well as identify the fungi from different sources. So now coming to the getting into the details of the experiment, let us see what is meant by this fungi. So we all know that fungi is nothing but a eukaryotic cell which is made up of rigid cell wall which is made up of chitin. So fungal cell wall is made up of chitin. So we can divide this fungi fungal into three types: yeast, molds and dimorphism, where yeast are nothing but the unicellular fungi which are reproduced by the budding, whereas molds are multicellular fungi which are reproduced by the sexual reproduction, whereas dimorphism is nothing but the fungi which is having both the characteristics of yeast as well as the mold. So mostly this is because of the presence of genetic switch, and most of the dimorphism fungi belongs to the pathogens. And one more important thing, yeast will be grown at 37 degrees centigrade, that is at the body temperature, whereas molds will be grown at 25 degrees centigrade, that is room temperature. Now coming to the one more thing, you can see it here, the diagram of the yeast where budding can be seen clearly. So this is a mother cell and these are the smaller one are the daughter cells. Now coming to the molds, which are multicellular, the body structure will be called as the hyphae. So these hyphae will form the mycelium, which are nothing but thin thread like structures or cottony growth, you can see it on the plate. So that cottony growth will be called as the mycelium. So these thread like structures, there are two types, say aseptate and septate. Here this wall has been not divided into different cells, so this type of hyphae we will be calling it as aseptate, where each cell has been divided with the common cell wall, which is known as the septate. So hyphae is of two types, aseptate and septate. Okay, now coming to the common examples of fungi. So fungi basically divided into lower fungi, sac fungi and glutinomycetes. So now coming to the lower fungi, which is known as phycomycetes, the good examples under that are rhizopus, mucor, etc. Whereas coming to the sac fungi, the examples include like ascomycetes, the example includes like yeast, aspergillus and penicillium. Now coming to the glutinomycetes, the good example is fusarium. So why I am discussing about this one means we are going with the identification of the fungi also. So you need to observe the fungi under the microscope and you need to identify which fungi is that. For that you should know the detailed structure of different types of fungi. So that's why I have drawn some pictures of the different commonly available fungi, commonly isolated fungi. For example, if you go with the first class, that is lower fungi, mucor and rhizopus. So here you can see the diagrams of the mucor and rhizopus, which is made up of sporangium. The sac-like structure is known as the sporangium, and inside you can see the sporangiospores. But the only difference between mucor and the rhizopus here is you can see the root-like structures at the base, which is known as the rhizopus, whereas mucor does not have those root-like structures. You need to remember this plays an important role during the identification of the fungi using the staining technique. So please remember, rhizopus will be having the rhizoid, whereas the mucor will not have those rhizoids. Okay, now coming to the rhizopus and penicillium, which will be coming under sac fungi. Okay, so rhizopus, here it is made up of conidia. Instead of sporangiophores, it will be having the conidia and phyliacs and vesicle. The central part is known as the vesicle, stem-like structure on which the conidia will be formed. Now coming to the penicillium, the same structure type will be there, metula will be there and conidia will be there at the tip. The basic difference between here is the penicillium structure will be like brush-like. Okay, when you observe under the microscope, the penicillium will be look like brush-like, painting brush. So that is the easy to identify the penicillium species. Now coming to the yeast and the fusarium, as we know, we all know that yeast cells can be easily identified because you can see the budding there, whereas the fusarium, you can see the hawk moon shaped cells which are nothing but the fusarium. So these are the common fungi which are, why I explained, because it is easy to identify when you go with the observation under the microscope. Now coming to the how to isolate these fungi from different samples, whether it is a water sample or soil sample or food sample, the process will be same, the procedure will be same. These are the some of the common agar medium which will be used to isolate the fungi. First one is Everoes agar, PDA agar, potato dextrose agar, cornmeal agar and V8 juice agar. But most commonly Everoes agar and PDA agar will be used for isolation of fungi. Please remember. Now we will see about the PDA, potato dextrose agar. So how to prepare this potato dextrose agar? For that we require potatoes, glucose, agar. Only three ingredients are required to prepare the PDA. Now how to go with the procedure? Boil 200 grams of potato which are peeled as well as sliced into small pieces and boil them in 500 ml of distilled water. After boiling, filter the extract by using the cheesecloth and then to that filtrate whatever has been obtained, to that we will be adding 20 grams of glucose and 20 grams of agar, and we need to make up to 1000 ml by adding extra amount of distilled water, and pH has to be maintained 5.5 before giving for autoclave. So this is the procedure to prepare the PDA medium. Now the media is ready. Now how to plate the sample onto the PDA plates? The same procedure. So whatever the soil sample or the fruit sample, whatever you had selected to isolate the organism from it, that sample has to be taken, serially dilute, and then each dilution has to be plated onto the PDA plates, and those PDA plates has to be incubated at 25 degrees centigrade. Please remember, for bacteria we are incubating at 37 degrees centigrade, for fungi we are incubating at room temperature, or you can say it as 25 degrees centigrade for 3 to 4 days. So no need to keep the plates inside the incubator when you are isolating the fungi. We can place the plates outside the incubator, that is at the room temperature. Please remember that point. Now after 3 to 4 days, if you find any cottony growth on the plate, that indicates that fungi has been grown on that plate. Now how to stain this fungi or how to observe this fungi under the microscope? So the staining technique which has been involved to identify the fungi is known as lactophenol cotton blue. Please remember, the staining technique is called as lactophenol cotton blue. So this lactophenol cotton blue is made up of major three ingredients. Those are phenol, lactic acid and cotton blue. So this phenol is used as a disinfectant which will be killing the organism, and lactic acid will be used to preserve the fungal structure, whereas cotton blue is used to stain the cell wall. Now how to go with the staining procedure? For that we need to take the clean glass slide, place a drop of 70% ethanol at the center of the slide, and then inoculate the fungal culture into this drop of ethanol by using the inoculating loop, sterile inoculating loop, and tease the sample using the needle. There will be a needle by using, we need to tease the sample. We need to spread out the cottony growth or the mycelium which has been there in that. So the main step is this one only. You need to be clear with this one. Nicely we need to tease out the mycelium present on the glass slide. Then to that, add one or two drops of lactophenol cotton blue and cover that area on the stain with the cover slip without any air bubbles. After that, immediately we need to observe under the microscope. You can go with 10x as well as the 45x. So when you observe under the microscope, the fungal structures will be stained as the dark blue and the background will be light blue in color. So already I explained how the different structures will be looked differently under the microscope. Based upon the specific structures, you can identify which fungal species is that. Thank you, students. Hello students, today we'll see the another experiment which is isolation as well as identification of fungi. So we are isolating as well as identifying which type of fungi is it. So for that we require the, I mean the PDA agar medium, which is nothing but the potato dextrose agar medium. Now I will show how to go with that preparation of PDA medium. After that I'll show how to stain. Identification means obviously we need to stain the culture. So I mean lactophenol cotton blue is the stain. So lactophenol cotton blue is the stain which will be used to stain the fungal cultures. Okay. So first I'll show how to go with the PDA preparation, potato dextrose agar. So for that we require potatoes, about 200 grams of potatoes, which should be nicely washed and cleaned, and peeled and sliced into small pieces. And those small pieces of potato should be boiled in about 500 ml of distilled water. Okay, so like I am not preparing that now, already I am done. So here you can see that boiled potato extract has been there. So where I had took about 50 grams of potato pieces and I had boiled in 100 ml of distilled water, and I had got the potato extract. So this I am filtering because there will be some residues will be left off. So that potato extract has to be filtered by using the cheesecloth. So now we are ready with the potato, boiled potato extract. Okay, to this we need to add the agar-agar as well as the glucose, which is nothing but the dextrose. Only three components for the preparation of PDA: glucose as well as the agar-agar. About 2 grams of each component has to be added into the 100 ml of potato extract. So already I had weighed the agar agar as well as the dextrose by using the weighing machine. So now I am adding to this potato extract about 2 grams of dextrose and 2 grams of agar. Okay. So we need to dissolve it and wrap it with the newspaper and give it for sterilization. That you know, we need to give it for autoclaving for 121 degree centigrade for about 15 minutes. By that time we will be ready with the PDA medium. Okay, so this has to go for the autoclaving now. So already I had prepared the PDA medium by using, either we can go with the individual ingredients like potatoes as well as the glucose and the agar, or else we can use the high medium. So here you can see the high medium which is labeled as potato dextrose agar. So I had dissolved about 3.6 grams of PDA in 100 ml of water and had gave it for sterilization. So now I am ready with the PDA medium which has been sterilized. So like this you can see the sterilized PDA medium. Okay, so whatever the prepared medium has been there, that has to be poured into the sterile petri plates. So that also I have been done. So the respective PDA medium I have been plated, I have been poured into the sterile petri plates. Now we are ready with the medium soap. Okay, now the next important one is the source from where we need to isolate the fungal cultures. Either you can go with your own interested sample like soil sample or food sample or water sample, anything. But now I am using the soil sample from where we are interested to isolate the fungal cultures. So I had dispensed about 1 gram of soil sample in 10 ml of water, and we need to go with for the seedle dilution. So now I am isolating the culture, fungal cultures, by using the from the soil sample. So that soil sample has to be serially diluted now. So for that we need to be ready with the test tubes. Okay, mix this stock solution properly. And from this one, take about 1 ml and go for the serial dilution. So this is the first tube into which I am dispensing 1 ml. Mix it properly by using the pipette and take out about 1 ml from this first tube and insert into the second tube. Mix it and take 1 ml from this one and dispense into the next tube, which is nothing but the 10 to the power of minus 3 dilution. Okay, from this one take it out. So every time you need to mix it properly and then take the sample. Okay, so that is important here. Okay, mix it. Take the sample and go for the next dilution. So if you are interested, you can go up to 10 to the power of minus 10 dilution, but here I am showing only up to 10 to the power of minus 5 dilution. So obviously we need to take out the sample from here and discard. From the last sample, always you should remember that take out 1 ml sample and discard it, then only it will become that respective dilution. So here I have shown only up to 10 to the power of minus 5 dilution. You can go up to 10 to the power of minus 10 dilutions also. So now we are done with the serial dilution of the soil sample, and next we need to start the plating. For that, we require the spreader. Okay, now we need to plate these dilutions into the respective plates. So already I had said I had poured the media into the plates. Now we are ready with the plates. So before that, take the sample. Take the sample and spread it on the media. Okay. So for that we require the spreader. So I am sterilizing the spreader by using the spirit. Okay. Pull it and then start spreading onto the plate. Nicely you need to spread throughout the surface of the medium. Okay. So like this you need to go with all the plates with the respective dilutions. I had shown only one plate, but you need to go with all the plates. Okay. So this plate has to be incubated at which temperature we are interested in isolating the fungal culture. So this has to be incubated at room temperature itself, not in the incubator. So you can leave the plates outside the incubator for about 3 to 4 days. You can see the growth of the fungal cultures. So how can you see the fungal cultures on the plate? So this is the result. Like this you can see after incubation for 3 to 4 days, you can see the growth of the fungal onto the medium. Okay, so that's fine cottony growth you can see. Right, mom? So this is the result you will be getting after the incubation. Now I will show how to stain the fungal cultures, how to observe them under the microscope. For that we need to go with the lactophenol cotton blue staining. For that we need to take the clean glass slide. Okay, clean glass slide onto which, take the fungal culture by using the inoculating glue.
needles in
there. Two needles in there. Pink color needle.
So I am sterilizing the loom. Pull it near the flame only. Open the plate and please be away from the plate because the spores will be there. As soon as you open the plate, the spores will be released outside. So you should be very careful with the fungal plates. Slowly open the plate. Take out the culture. So you can see very little amount I took it and I am placing onto the glass slide. Okay. Again sterilize and put it back. Okay, so here you can see very very little amount of culture has been there on the slide. So now important step here is you need to tease the culture, you need to spread out the mycelium. Now we will tease the culture by using the needle. So this is a crucial step. If you tease it properly, then only you can see the fungal structure very clearly. So nicely you need to tease it. Okay, that means we are separating the cottony growth mycelium from each one so that we can observe it neatly when we observe under the microscope. So I had tears the sample, then add a drop of lactophenol cotton blue. Okay, and for this you need to cover with the cover slip. So gently place the cover slip onto the So like this you need to place the cover slip onto the sample. So this has to be observed under the microscope under 10x as well as the 45x. Thank you.